Now, let's look at the Wavedig Studio, the music mapping software we did. I'm using it together with the Magic Music Visuals, an awesome little piece of kit and not too expensive. So check it out. When you're not using it with Modulate, make sure you have the MIDI events off and the send phase off. Anyway, there's basically 16 scenes down here and you can fill them with effectors. Well, basically you have your steppers, so this one is stepping forward for every beat that is analyzed from the music real time. This one is the curve, where you can draw your own curves, and the vertical lines correspond to the time base you have selected. So it can be bars, or it can be beats. Put it on, like now it's two beats the whole length, but if I put it at one bar, now it's four bars, and so on, you get the drill. So let's try connecting it to something. So we just put something here, let's see, polygon. Polygons are nice. So let's connect the step effector to the amount of faces polygon has. For that, I'm gonna solo it, so that ensures nothing else is going out but the singular effector you have selected. And now when I use the MIDI learn function, I click listen, and now it has detected the note that comes out of Wavedig Studio. And I need to put some scale to it, because otherwise it's under one all the time. Right, so you see how it works. Let's add scale. And for this we use the curve effector, because it's smooth change of values. So solo that, and then we teach it to both of the X and Y parameter. Oh yeah, X and Y is it. Now we remove the solo and we have both of those effects together. Other effectors include the function effector, which is similar to the curve that it makes, but it makes the predefined functions like a triangle or sine waves, stuff like that. The init effector is interesting, because that you can use to denote the change of scene when you go further automating the stuff. So, and that's what I use in Magic when I change scene here, and I get a scene change also in Magic. So all of the 16 scenes have their own effectors. And if you want to copy an effector from scene to another, you just drag it here. And now you have the same one here. All right, that should get you started. Send me if you have any questions or anything. One thing about the curve effector, you can straighten or make it round like this by double clicking. Remember that. All right, have fun.